What is cloud seeding? Cloud seeding is a form of weather modification used to increase rainfall, especially over agricultural land. In 1946, chemist Vincent Schaefer was involved in research at the General Electric Laboratory in New York. He was trying to form artificial clouds in a chilled chamber. One day, when he thought the chamber was too warm, he added dry ice in an effort to cool it. A cloud formed, as the ice crystals provided a nucleus around which water droplets would collect. Water droplets surround ice crystals in the same way during natural rain formation. Using an airplane, Dr. Schaefer was able to replicate this dry ice effect with natural clouds over Massachusetts. Later, scientists would use silver iodide, whose crystal structure allows for similar effects. Since the discovery of this method, cloud seeding has been put to use globally with varying effectiveness. Still, cloud seeding was credited with having created 52 artificial rainstorms over the deserts of Abu Dhabi. It is currently in use in countries like the United States, Argentina, Australia, China, and the UAE. Reverse cloud seeding was even used to prevent rain at the Beijing Olympics opening ceremony in 2008. Approaching storms were seeded so that they would release their precipitation before they reached the complex. Even in dry areas, the air contains some water. Rainfall occurs when these droplets of water form around other particles in the air, like dust, and become too heavy to remain suspended. The droplets then fall and form rain. Cloud seeding works by inducing nucleation. Nucleation is the formation of a new structure. Essentially, the process introduces more particles for the water in the air to crystallize around, which leads to increased rainfall. Silver iodide is a common chemical used, as well as calcium chloride, especially in warm or tropical climates. Two different types of seeding agents are used depending on the temperature of the cloud volume to be treated. The cold rain process involves ice particles, whereas the warm rain process is entirely liquid. There are three methods of cloud seeding: static, where the moisture is already present in the clouds, but chemicals like silver iodide provide crystals for the water to condense around and makes the clouds more effective at dispensing their water; dynamic, which increases vertical air movements, which make more water pass through clouds, meaning more crystals and therefore more rain. It requires a properly working sequence of events and is less dependable than the static method. Hygroscopic, which releases salts into the lower sections of clouds. The salts absorb water until they are fully saturated and they can no longer absorb any more water. It rains. This is the least studied method, but is thought to have the highest potential. As is often the case with water and weather and climate, it is impossible to carry out a completely controlled experiment. Therefore, in the areas of increased precipitation, we can't know whether or not it would have rained even if the clouds had not been seeded. Benefits of cloud seeding are that it boosts overall precipitation. The point of cloud seeding is adding particles that readily take up moisture, which retain water in the cloud. This is an efficient way of facilitating the water vapor transformation into liquid water, which is an important prereq for rainfall. Cloud seeding allows us to enhance precipitation efficacy, which boosts overall precipitation. It can also provide relief to drought-stricken areas. In the same way that cloud seeding can boost precipitation, the formation of rain is essential in drought-stricken areas. Using cloud seeding, these areas can produce rain, which may in turn alleviate the problem of water scarcity. Finally, it can also reduce crop damage. Just as cloud seeding can be used to boost the likelihood of rain, it can also be used to suppress precipitation that could be harmful to crops. For example, excessive snow could be suppressed just like hail or excessive rain, which would damage or drown crops. There are also several disadvantages to cloud seeding. In order for cloud seeding to work, we have to inject the atmosphere with particles that readily absorb water. Once we're done using these particles to absorb water, they don't just go anywhere. They will stay in the atmosphere. This is where the long-term effects of iodine come into play. One of the biggest chemicals that is used in cloud seeding is iodine, as previously mentioned. Currently, there are no harmful effects of using iodine, but extensive studies have also not been done, so this remains a bit of a mystery, and the lack of knowing is a drawback because it could potentially be harmful. Besides the health of animals, plants, and humans, there is also the cost of cloud seeding to consider. Delivering large amounts of chemicals to the sky and then injecting them into the air is extremely expensive and may not be a good investment since the long-term effects of iodide are not known. Lastly, although it is a positive that cloud seeding can lead to an increase in precipitation, currently there is no way to control how much rain falls, which could lead to flooding. In conclusion, there is a lot of uncertainty surrounding cloud seeding, but it stands as one of the strongest possibilities for modifying weather and therefore mitigating the effects of climate change.